We're here in Los Angeles. It's All-Star Weekend. What do you think about the change in the format? There's no East, West. You just got stars and the two top vote-getters picked the teams and all
that.
Of course, LeBron, picked Kevin Durant. It's first pick.
You know, supposed to pick. Yeah. Supposed to pick the best player available.
Yeah. All right, go ahead.
You know, it's
All-Star game.
I think that people need to take a step back because when I played an All-Star game, I was just here to have fun. It's never going to be game seven where guys out there trying to kill themselves because you have an obligation to your team. If I were to get hurt in an All-Star game, I would feel like I would let the city of Philadelphia or Phoenix down. I wish it would be a little bit more competitive.
Just a little bit.
Yeah, just a little bit. But
they play harder in summer leagues, man.
Yeah, but, you know, first of all, a lot of
practices in summer. I'm sorry,
I do. Stephen A., it is a really tough dilemma to try to get these. And then the people talk about, well, they're going to get a winner $100,000. I said, a guy making $35 million ain't going to get excited over $100,000. But I wish they would be a little bit more competitive. But I always tell people, man, just enjoy the weekend. It's a lot of fun. I just don't want it to turn into an alley-oop fest.
Well, that's my point. Yeah. I enjoy the weekend up until the damn game. To me, the least interesting part about the weekend is the actual All-Star game with the best players in the world.
That's true.
I want to see LeBron and Kyrie together, though. I'm not going to lie.
And if you're LeBron and KD, I would like to see you going up against KD instead of picking him.
Not even in the finals.
No, I want to see him playing
together. See him in the finals.
What do you think, Charles, about them not televising the draft?
It was stupid.
And supposedly the players didn't want to.
They should have televised the draft. And they were talking about guys hurting each other's feeling like.
That's the point. That's the point of televising it.
That's
why you want to see it.
They are grown men.
And that's the most interesting part, I feel like, watching them.
I was so disappointed in Adam Silver, who I love to death. And, like, it would have been great theater. But let me tell you, the way that LeBron's guys get hurt, and I've been saying, please don't pick me. The way his guys are dropping like flies.
Right. And I got to tell you something. You brought up Adam Silver, and we all know Adam Silver's a fantastic commissioner. You're going to succeed,
yes.
Stern. You need to be fantastic. And Adam Silver is absolutely fantastic. But I actually thought he hurt himself with that.
He did.
In terms of not televising it, because you showed a heightened level of sensitivity. I'm sitting there, Adam, don't you want to know who get picked and why?
Well,
why would you think the public would want to know?
Should the NBA soap opera be working for the NBA?
Well, I think the one thing that Adam's got to do, Adam is so pro-player. He's got to get to the point. Like, you know, he did great with Donald Sterling. Now he's got no back-to-backs. Now we got a long week break. He's got to get to the point where he's like, hey, you know what, guys? I've done everything y'all asking me to do.
Enough.
We're going to televise the draft. I'm not worried about guys' feelings. It would have been great drama to watch it.
I think they'll televise it next year.